Uber driver and picked up 327 passengers. I didn't actively count, but an estimated 100% said, wow, I've never had a female driver before. I remember one, male, stubbled, not my type, but definitely handsome, chiseled jaw and pearly white, deep-set eyes that bore into the rearview mirror. I've never had a female driver before, and a beautiful one at that. That day, I was wearing makeup, and as I thanked him for the compliment, he continued to shower me with praise. Intelligent, confident, independent. I know deep down it's just because I'm all made up and pretty. His words start to slip, the grease sliding its way into our banter, and I'm starting to fidget. The car is starting to feel a little crowded. The question starting to walk a delicate tightrope between polite and invasive. He asks me, do you have a boyfriend? And my single for God knows how long ass said, yes. When really, I meant to say no, and I'm not interested in you. No, and I'm not comfortable with you asking me that. No, and it really isn't your business to know. No, and you shouldn't feel entitled to know anything about my personal life. But I said yes. Because in that moment, trapped in a moving vehicle on a highway, the distance between his hand and my shoulder closing in like a palm on screaming lips, I felt like the only way I could escape a man's hold is to pretend I am already on another man's leash. Nearing the end of the trip, he claimed, humans are exhibitionists. We all love to show off. Men with their watches and shoes, women with their cosmetics. I told him I practice self-love by wearing makeup. He told me I was trying to impress him. I was trying to impress men like him. Men like him who confuse strength with being right. Men like him who treat other people's experiences like ghost stories. Men like him who don't recognize our knees are not made to bend for them, but to carry our weight and move us forward. Men like him are the reason friend zone exists. Yeah. That skirts have no pockets. That breastfeeding is disturbing in public. Men like him say, not all men. When we're saying, but enough of them do. We are saying bodies belong to those who were born with it. We are saying conversation is a two-way street. So listen, because women can drive their point across. Yes. We're saying if there's a wage gap, if there's a wage gap based on gender, we will make the 78 cents count for our next manicure. Yes. If we need to make babies instead of a career, we'll find the most appealing package for our co-creator. If we have to wear makeup to look professional or presentable, we are going to enjoy it. Appreciate the artistry and detail men can't appreciate anyway, and give our faces and hearts the respect and loving we deserve. Because one day, when my daughter decides to wear makeup and drive an Uber and gets harassed, she is going to say, no, I don't have a boyfriend and I don't need one.
All right. If you had an idea of what poetry is, that idea is applause right now. Another round of applause for
Give me five.